just because President Barack Obama endorsed Todd Stroger as a good progressive Democrat, you know now better because you feel the impact of his ill-advised decisions. Downtown Dorothy Brown.
Downtown Dorothy Brown.
Hypocrisy on the county board abounds. And although people like Larry Sufferton and Forrest Claypool feel that Todd is unfit for the job and should call for his resignation, in their heart and their mind, that they feel that deeply, passionately, they don't want to express it publicly because they feel they would alienate the African American voter base for their future political aspirations. The ironic thing is that in every race, countywide race, that I ran in, I had one or more offices opened, campaign offices opened in the African American neighborhoods on the South Side and the West Side, particularly the South Side. And when Forrest Claypool and Larry Sufferton ran countywide, neither one of them had any offices south of Madison Street. So that tells you a lot how much they want to really outreach to the area versus the rhetoric that's engaged in for political purposes, I think. I seriously doubt that he can get real. I think he's unelectable. But, you know, the friends that you mentioned are not unique in that regard, where the color of the skin was the predominant factor in their decision-making of whom to vote for. Even though Martin Luther King said, "Don't judge me by the color of my skin, judge me by the content of my character." I use that line in black neighborhoods throughout the city, constantly, just to remind them, knowing in advance that I wasn't going to get that support. And my support in the African-American community in 06 was between 8 and 18%. 18% in Hyde Park, which is kind of a mixed progressive area, 8% in some of the poor, economically disadvantaged African-American wards. So I was able to get a significant vote total for a white suburban Republican. Just because President Barack Obama endorsed Todd Stroger as a good progressive Democrat, you know now better because you feel the impact of his ill-advised decisions in closing the health clinics and reducing services in the hospitals that serve the African-American community, and really raising a tax on those who are least able to pay it. They recognize now that this monolithic, unquestioned support of the Democratic Party is hurting them financially. Their schools are a disaster, do not educate their kids. The economic devastation through the the food deserts, and if you can't find, there are, I think, two Starbucks south of Madison Street, and both run by, former basketball player Magic Johnson. Otherwise, they wouldn't be there either. Howard Brookings. They tried to knock him out of office because he wanted a Walmart store in a neighborhood that doesn't have any food stores. And would provide jobs and economic development, and would be an anchor to this huge shopping center on 87th Street, just east of, west of Dan Ryan Expressway. Why wouldn't you want it? I mean, the irony is that you have the finance committee chairman in the city council, Ed Burke, who publicly on the city council floor excoriates Walmart because they're not unionized, they're anti-union, anti-collective bargaining, they don't provide benefits, rely on public health care to provide health care to their workers. And then when the microphone and cameras are off, he hustles, and I mean hustles, Walmart for their business. He wants to represent them on real estate tax appeals. He wants to do their regulatory work. I mean, the duplicity is just numbing. But that's how he operates, and he's not alone. I mean, he's just the brightest example of that kind of hypocrisy.
Well, you've got Larry Sufferton, one of your associates, who is representing the operators of a trash dump over on, you're probably familiar with it, the Little Something River or Little Something Creek. And the township there is just...
Is there Fort Heights down? I'm not sure about the particular location, but Larry has a lot of lobbying clients. He represents the Restaurant Association, Abbott Labs, Chicago Bar Association. He's a partner in Shevsky and Froelich, which does extensive legal work for the county. Well, Larry Rogers, the commissioner on the County Board of Tax Appeals, is being now pushed by the elements of the regular Democratic Party to replace Todd as the endorsed candidate of the regular Democratic Party of Cook County, which would put candidate number 4 from the African American community. Roughly all are within, you know, 3-4 miles of each other.
Am I hearing that maybe the Cook County Democrat Party will do to Todd Stroger what the state party and even the national party is now kind of doing to Roland Burris? Will they shun him?
Yeah, I think that they will shun him, knowing that he is unelectable. And the Democratic Party of Cook County now, and for some time already, has been kind of a collection of city-states prior to Garibaldi's uniting Italy in 1880. You know, they had all these city-states, principalities. That's how Cook County regular Democratic fiefdoms are organized. They're all around families, the Banks, the Madigans, the Lipinskis, the Strogers, the Daleys, the Hines, the... You got all these families, it's kind of like Cosa Nostra, and they get together once a year and they try to divide up the turf. And that's what passes for politics and government in Crook County. And then, of course, you've got this current movement, which now I think involves about 10 townships who have passed referendum questions by overwhelming margins in the primary elections last year and this year, 70 percentile, asking and supporting secession from Cook County. So it is a growing movement, but you would need to have each of these townships and the city pass it by 51% vote. And these are non-binding referendums, by the way. And then you need to have the whole county vote by 51% to allow them to secede. So it's a two-step process.
So yeah, it's
rather difficult, not impossible, but difficult. I think it's a powerful message that's sent to all levels of government, federal, state, county, township, and municipal. When a collection of individuals like we did in Lyons Township, where I'm a committeeman, township that has 120,000 residents. We voted, I think it was like 82% to secede. Riverside was in the 70 percentile. So I think it sends a powerful message that we're not happy as a community with the status quo. It indicates to, I think, all of the county commissioners and to President Todd Stroger and his administration that the message that they hear when they hold these town hall meetings throughout the suburban Cook County, which turn out to be hostile venting sessions against Todd Stroger and his administration, that these are not accidental, kind of select small group of people who feel that way, that there is a widespread feeling that his policies are not enjoying the support of the vast majority of the people in the suburban Cook County area. And I would venture to say in the city, you would have a significant portion of the people who would, if given an opportunity, for example, to cast a vote whether to recall Todd Stroger as County Board President or not, that they would vote in favor of a recall.
And is Cook County set up with such a mechanism for that?
None.